Hey, Samurai, really quick, what's it like to spar Virgil? He's very talented.
Well, bad
how is he sparring?
He's a monster, bro.
Dude. How hard does he hit? How hard does...
Yeah, pega.
Fuerte.
Yeah.
Now, you're very good, too.
Sí, sí, es un 154 libras.
Yeah.
What do you think, him and Delorme, your prediction?
KO.
What round?
Pues si bien pinche vato ese, yo creo que no pasa del 4.
No more than 4.
Yeah.
I like the confidence. That's good.
That's it, 2.
2.
Y luego le ayudó a esparrar el samurai menos.
No, it's good. It was good sparring. So Devin Haney says Ryan is a C-class fighter, and he says that he quit his last fight. Does that help?
Ryan didn't quit his last fight.
That's what he's. Okay, but okay. So he forgot about that fight.
He beat.
Yeah, Oscar, and Oscar's really good.
Oscar's
legit.
Yeah.
Good person too. Now in this gym, he's even happier.
Yeah, he's training hard.
So he's Oscar's fighting in 12 days. Virgil's fighting in 12 days. And Jose.
And the other kid that they have. But Siegel.
But he's here.
Siegel. You know, the event's already sold out in like a week.
Was it already?
Yeah, people want floor seats and none available.
Nothing available.
That's not easy to sell out. So this weekend, Robert, Ryan went from Dallas to Vegas, was there for 3 days, now to New York. What do you think? Yeah, he came to support his brother at a press conference. Then he met some adult star, some lady named Savannah something.
Who knows that?
He posted.
Maybe they're trying to just fuck around. People believe everything they see.
He did a video with her that they're getting engaged and married. He took her to New York.
Exactly. They could do shit like that just for people, just so people can think that he's not doing things right. You know, all that shit is part of promoting a fight and making people believe that you're not ready.
So you don't believe any of that?
It would be stupid enough to do shit like that if it was real the week of the fight.
Nobody ever does that.
Nobody does that. That was just,
you have to make way.
His brother, then they fucking did it, you know, fucking around just so people could, oh, he's not gonna be ready. Oh, he's not gonna be asking. It's a shame, man.
He says he's gonna knock out Haney.
Well, I don't know about
he said
that,
two rounds.
He
said 2 rounds. He's gonna hurt him in the first.
He does it hard.
You don't think so? You don't think too much? You're not going to New York? By the way, how's Mexico this weekend?
We left at 4 in the morning.
Pantera, get ready.
Our flight at 6 in the morning.
That's cutting it close. That's badass, though. No sleep. How was the concert?
Both
a lot of people? You were at the ESPN card.
Yeah, we had on Saturday, we were not allowed to stay 4 hours nonstop. We slept all day Sunday morning. Sunday during the day, we slept all day. And then the next concert last night, Alfredo Olivas started at midnight, ended at 4, went to the hotel, picked up our stuff, go to the...
You weren't stressed out or that you're going to miss your flight?
No, because we knew our flight left at 6:20.
Yeah, but here you have to be a certain time for the check-in.
Yeah, but we already had carry-on, and we knew we already checked in. So we got there an hour before, and we were fine.
How long is the flight?
3 hours.
You slept?
So that's the time I slept. So we haven't slept. That's when, and then from the airport, from Tijuana, drove straight to here.
Wow. To the gym?
Yeah. Straight here.
Yeah. That's wild.
Yeah.
But it was worth it.
It was worth it. Alfredo, Julian, they're good, man.
I showed up today and there was a lot of spaces in the parking. I thought nobody's coming today.
No, but it started.
Yeah, 12 o'clock.
Because I told
yeah.
everybody to show up at 12 because I had a feeling I was going to make it on time. But I got here at 10, so...
Okay, so let me ask you your prediction.
More than
Oscar Duarte is fighting Jojo Diaz. Virgil's fighting Thomas Delorme. And Jose Ramirez is fighting Barthelemy. What's your prediction for those three?
Well, you know, I hate to say it because, you know, you got to respect every fighter, every opponent. But I do predict all three by knockout. I think all three by knockout. That's my prediction. But, you know, I can't also guarantee that either because, you know, Bartolome has good experience. Jojo's never been stopped, never been knocked out. So, it was George. He's never going to, you know, so. I'm thinking Duarte is just so strong that he might stop him. So, you know, Virgil, I think we'll stop Duarte.
Virgil's in great shape. Jose's in great shape. And everybody's in great shape. But Robert, how did Duarte end up in your gym?
His manager called me. I've known him for many years. I've dealt with him, you know, some fights before. And he approached me, told me that Duarte wanted to try out my gym. So.
You like taking these fighters that people wrote off that are quote unquote broken? They're not.
Challenges for me too.
And then he'll become a world champion here. What?
Challenges for me.
He fights at what weight?
Bandera, how many ounces are you shooting? Your gloves?
20.
You need some new ones.
Yeah, I got some.
The fuck? You got some you used to wear in this ones?
These are my last. I had to
get in, get in.
So they're retired with this cap? Better be retired. Look at that one over there.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Yeah. But I was gonna say because they look big.
What brand is it, Robert?
They're retired winnings.
What? But winnings are very. Show me this. Winnings are very expensive gloves. Why did they look like?
I had them for a while.
Not 20. 20? How long?
The thing is that he's got two. So why is he still wearing
this one? Let me see this.
I was gonna retire them either way.
It looks like Crawford's glove when he fought that guy in Omaha. The Armenian kid. Wait, so I don't understand. How long have you had them? Those gloves are very expensive. They're like $800, Robert. Is it worth fixing them or not really?
No, they're ready to be retired. He's got new ones.
Well, he shouldn't be using them if they're that bad. Pantera, are you getting ready for bare knuckle? That's how bare knuckle gloves are, right?
You got approved here in California.
Who did?
Bare knuckle fights.
They did?
Yeah,
you have anybody that could do it?
They had a show, in California, bare knuckle.
You have anybody that could do bare knuckle here?
No, but they had a show. It's already commissioned by Shenzhen. I think last week.
Yeah. No, that's cool. Hey, why not? Let these fighters make money. Pierre Angulo's going to fight BKFC.
Yeah? I think Mike Alvarado.
Yeah, he was.
Fantastic, I
heard. The kid from El Paso, he won a few big fights there.
Who was that?
The southpaw, that fought Canelo.
Kirkland.
Oh, Kirkland?
No.
Oh,
no.
No. He's from New
Mexico. Last name like a fish.
From New Mexico.
Trout.
Wow. Like a fish. Last name like a fish.
It is. A trout's a fish. Yeah, but he's from Houston. Yeah. But listen, if you can make money in BKFC, go get money. Yeah. New Mexico. Oscar Duarte getting ready. 12 days to fight night. Working very hard. Reporting, man, a lot of talent here. Look, future world champion. Right there, future world champion right here. Virgil, Jose. Bam's a champion. You got like 5-6. What's his name?
Emiliano Alvarado.
Is he? Where?
In Guadalajara.
Emiliano, how old are you? Young. You don't want to go to the Olympics? Why not? You want to make money? Smart? What weight? 115? 118. How close? How many amateur fights? What's your amateur record? Who's your favorite fighter all time? And your favorite fighter today?
Inouye.
I think Bam knocks out Inoue when they fight.
It's too big, Alex.
No, they can make. They can make. Bam's gonna move up. Pantera looks big in sparring. I don't know what the guy's sparring with. Monster.